Hello, I'm Mr. Armiger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. I can prove, you know, why praying is antichrist, praying and fasting, as they do it in monks and monastery, they do it. Then they are calling themselves fathers, as if we do not know our Father which is inside us, and they have Father in heaven. Now, this is the temple of God. If this is the temple of God, then this is the house of God. Where I'm sitting here, this is the house of Niger, my house. So I'm sitting here, not somebody else. Same, this is the temple of God. God is inside me. That's why Jesus said, those who have seen me have seen my Father. Because his qualities of the Father, Jesus displayed. Same, we are like Jesus. We are sons of the Most High. Our Jesus was the anointed Son of the Most High, and he made the other people the sons of the Most High, our Father inside us. So people who pray from their mouth, they say Father is in heaven, not inside. Whereas Jesus said, before the thing come in from your mouth, he already knows what is in your heart. So you don't need to pray. Pharisee, Sadducee, disciple of John the Baptist, they used to pray and fast, not in Jesus. In Jesus, our Father knows everything. So those who pray, saying that Father in heaven, that Father has gone out from this temple into the heaven. And this temple has been occupied, is vacant, and it has been occupied by Satan. That is why you find these Christians, you know, calling themselves Christians, Sikhs and other things, that they are not truthful. They are unrighteous liars. So when you are liar and untruthful, that is not befitting our Father. Was Jesus a liar? Was any apostle a liar? No. So those who become liars, for them, you know, this house is occupied by Satan. And when this has been occupied Satan, then that is why the Father is in heaven, not inside them. So those are antichrist. People who are righteous, because in Jesus we are slave to righteousness and no more to sins. Sins used to be transgression against the moral law, and sins are against scripture. Transgression of the scripture is sin. So moral laws were made by Moses, and they were for natural person, natural man. When you are born, this is the nature, this body is of nature. So when you are born, you are a natural man. Unless you become spiritual, you can't understand gospel. So to discipline the natural man, the rabbis make them to obey the scripture or the moral laws. So those who want to learn and obey the moral laws, they are called disciples. So the rabbis, Pharisees, Sadducees, they used to have disciples. And disciples did what their master told them to do, rabbi told them to do. In Jesus, we have been set free. We are not bound. Jesus doesn't compel us to do things, but we do it for our own pleasure. We find in God pleasure, not in mammon. So that is why we want to have the treasures of our Father and not of mammon. Mammon we need it to live, but when you have become greedy, then you have a blood called greed blood. Remember Judas Iscariot. He took 30 silver coins from the temple priest to catch Jesus. But when that Jesus, after being caught, was killed, then that 30 coins become blood money, which he would not take it to his home. He had conscience. He knew Jesus to be Son of God. So he dare not take the money into his house. He said, no, this is blood money. I don't want it. Same, you know, people who are honest. They have God in their heart. Righteous people. God is righteousness. God is not moral laws. Moral laws are for natural men, for disciples. We are laborers working in the vineyard of our Father. So we do not pray or fast. And praying and fasting used to be ritual in the synagogues, temple, where they were praying to Yahweh. That is the Father in heaven. And that Jewish prayer they have inserted into the New Testament or in the books, you know, for people to pray. That is not Jesus. Jesus never said prayer. He contemplated with our Father. He meditated with our Father. And he was always in the company of our Father, because Father lived in him, not up there. So we always thank our Father for his blessing. So Jesus had the, our Father is supernatural. The natural man of Yahweh, who worship Yahweh, he obeys the natural moral laws and natural senses. These natural senses, they are all mathematics, physics, chemistry, they all are the study of nature. But our Father, he is above nature, he is supernatural. In nature you make sin. In supernatural you don't make sin. So because we are in of the sons of the Most High, we belong to supernatural royal kingdom of our Father. Those who are the not twice born, once born, they belong to the natural world. In the natural world, you don't know the supernatural Father, so you say prayer to demiurge God Yahweh. He is not real, he is shadow, unreal. Like this one, this is shadow of what is inside me of God. That is real. Make me living. This, if the inside thing is gone, is dead and useless. It goes into the earth. Even in the house, they say, oh, now he has turned into a ghost. Bury him, burn him away, throw him out of the house. So the real thing is, what is inside you, that is of our supernatural Father. We have one Father. That is why in Jesus, all the righteous people of the world, they have one Father, same as one in each of them. One Father reflects in each of person, you know. So this is the age. And when you get Father in your heart, then you earn your rest, because that is the house of the Father, and he will give you the rest in his house when you die. So be careful, you know, those people who say prayers and do fasting to please Father. We don't need fast. We are sensible. We know how much to eat. We don't overeat it, that you need fasting. If we need to do fasting because our stomach is upset and this and that, that is our joy. If we are not forced to do the fasting, we don't obey any laws, because supernatural sons of God, they are above nature and above the natural laws. We go by spirit, as the Samaritans and Gentiles did go. That is why Philip said, a Gentile never dies, for he does not live to die, because they belong to the supernatural Father. That is why Jesus never did not come to be Gentile. He came to the Jews. That is why he offered himself for baptism by John the Baptist. John the Baptist was baptizing them in the name of Abraham, to make them the sons of Abraham. And that's why Jesus, when he was in the temple, he told the people over there, Jewish people there, that your fathers are devil, because they were not sons of Abraham. He said, if you were the sons of Abraham, you would have honored me. But as you are not of sons of Abraham, your fathers are devil. Same. If the Father is not inside you, then you are saying prayer to Father in heaven, which is devil, shadow one. So the real Father is inside, not over there. So John the Baptist baptized in the name of Abraham only the Jewish men, no Gentile or a woman. That is why Jesus offered himself to John the Baptist to do the baptism. And John the Baptist baptized Jesus in the name of Yahweh. Jesus was the firstborn of Yahweh. That is why he called second Adam. And the Jewish people, when they become Jews outwardly, not of the heart. A Jew is one who is inwardly, not outwardly. When they become Jew outwardly, then they break their covenant with Abraham. Abraham was not a Jew. He was Semitic race, a Semite. So these Jews who become Jews outwardly, they become anti-Semitic themselves. And also they become anti-Abraham. They are no more sons of Abraham, and also no more sons of Yahweh. Yahweh is the creator of Adam and Eve and all that. It was Yahweh who told Abraham, leave your kith and kin and go and settle in the place which is the promised land. It was Yahweh who was feeding people when they were faithful to Abraham. The land used to be lush green, as mentioned in the parable of the prodigal son. The father is Abraham, the prodigal son, the younger one, is Isaac and his people. The elder one is Ishmael, Arab people. Arab people remained faithful to Abraham. And also they were eating meager. They were not as well fed as of Isaac. Because Isaac was the real father, real son of Abraham. Whereas the Ishmael people, they were the sons of Abraham out of slave women. So they were not favored so much as Isaac. At the same time, when the Isaac became unfaithful to Abraham, he kicked them out of the promised land. And he sent them to Egyptian to beg food from them. Whereas they used to be very proud, arrogant. Hey, we get all the honey and milk land. Egyptian, they are struggling. So that's why when the son, in prodigal son, he returned back and father embraced him and he got fattened calf and everything. Then Ishmael said, hey father, I was with you all the time. You never gave me that type of treatment. And you are this son, you come from exile. Under the Egyptian Exodus, Moses brought them back. Then you are treating them like anything. So that is to tell you what the Jewish people promised them. So what the Isaac people have great, great blessing in Abraham. But as soon as they become unfaithful to Abraham, they become the sons of Satan, tares. Matthew 13:24-30, tares. Sons of Satan. And now today they are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning. So that is why you don't find peace in Israel or his neighbors. There will be trouble. And that, Jesus said, when the end of the world come, I will bundle up the tear in Israel and then burn them through atomic war, which is expected in 2018, when Israel is 70 years old. Remember, temple was destroyed when Jesus, from the birth of Jesus to 70 years. 70 is the number of Sanhedrin members. 10 times 7. So much I have put down is all through, comes from your heart. It's not written in the book. That is why it is called revelation. University professors, they read books and they vomit it out without understanding. And I laugh at them when I go to Oxford University. So I ask them simple question. First of all, now they know me and they don't want to ask me any question. If I try to put my hand up, they ignore me. Because they know, you know, that this man asks awkward question. So they have no knowledge of theology, but they have become the cornerstones of the churches. Whose churches are they? Not of God. They are the blind guide leading the blind into the pit. As they are blind, so they have so many ways spread over If they have eyes to see, then they will know they are united. They will have one fold, one shepherd, Christ Jesus. The fold is Church of God, headed by Jesus, not Church of England, headed by Queen, head of Mammon. So they go to churches in England, worship Mammon, and they are very happy that we are members of the Church of England. But Church of England glorifies the people who killed people overseas. The soldiers who died in the expansion of the empire, they say they have glorified God. Which God? Not our Father, Mammon God, money. So be sensible. You know it what I'm saying. But you pretend, you know, that you have deaf ears. Same Jesus, when he was preaching in Jerusalem, they knew what he was preaching, but they turned their deaf ears to him. So, up to you. Our Father God blesses everyone as rain falls on good and bad people without any discrimination.